Get ready to match the stars. So welcome back, Connor, on Palillo. Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn!
Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Nice to have you with us. Okay, buddy.
It's the Christmas spirit.
Yeah, it is the Christmas spirit. You're full of jolly good things, aren't you? And this is the Friday before Christmas, just in case it slipped anybody's mind. Charles?
No, it didn't slip my mind, Gene. I'm still getting over last Christmas.
Well, now, wait a minute, Charles. This is the last show before Christmas is Sunday.
I personally don't care.
Yeah, but now, wait a minute. You did it one year. You played Santa Claus, and you were wonderful.
No, I played it for 4 years.
For 4 years, yes.
It was a tradition.
It was excellent.
And last year, I was not given a costume, and I was told I couldn't be Santa Claus.
Oh. But we want you to be Santa Claus.
In April, I was under treatment. Over the rejection. So this year, I will not accept it.
Oh,
I hit two men on the street that were with the bells and the little pots. I just hit them out of just anger and sheer upsetment. So I don't care.
But we want you to do it, Charles. We are pleading with you.
We are pleading
with you.
I'm sorry.
I'll get down on my knees.
I couldn't compete against that Italian marriage flag.
I'm down on my knees. Wait a minute.
No.
You're upstaging, Charles. What the heck is that?
A funeral. No. I mean, I'm not coming out. First of all, that wig makes my toupee have dandruff, that cheap white wig. And I'm too thin to be Santa.
Well, I'm quite disappointed that you're not going to be Santa.
I'm glad.
What is that?
Well, a gentleman caller brought it to my dressing room, Mr. Douglas Smart of the Lawrence Welk Show. Isn't it pretty?
Yeah.
Well, it's wax.
It's plastic, if you want to get technical. But isn't it pretty?
Oh, yes, of course. It's beautiful. And he just brought it as a token of his affection for you and his esteem for you. Well,
yes.
We all hold
that
you
sweet?
In high
Thank
regard.
You.
Listen. It was in payment of favors bestowed.
Charles.
Ah!
Would you do it now? Would you play Santa if I bring you a little gift?
Ho, 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 anywhere near that.
Oh. Well, I'm sorry about that. Let's say hello to Christy Piper and Glenn Weiss. Now, Christy is the current champ. She has an even $7,000. And as the time expired last time, we just met Glenn Weiss, and we discovered that she teaches people to dive for treasure with self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. And as you can see, she would have no difficulty in breathing underwater. Now, would she? Yes. How long have you been doing this, then?
7.5 years.
Yes. So you must be very good. You can stay under for a long time and swim a great distance. And have you ever found anything valuable?
Well, I'm not really supposed to talk about it, but we do have a museum.
Oh, you do?
Yes, we do. Everything we bring up, we're supposed to share with the British government, but we sort of pick what we want to keep. And we built a museum.
Shall we turn her in?
I'll just get all the information.
Yes, sir. Write it all down, sir. Hello, Scotland Yard. Well, good luck anyway.
British
government.
You may need the money to keep one step ahead of the law here. We'll start here with round one right after we do a little business with you. Here we go. Round one coming up. Glenn, it's your choice, A or B.
B, please.
All right, you got it. This is it. Mm-hmm. Hey! Did you see the two new statues in the park?
No.
Well, one is President Grant on his horse. The other is President Ford on his blink.
You can't say that.
Yes, he can. Now, wait a minute. Check and double check, as Amos and Andy used to say.
Would I lie to you?
Yes.
You can say this.
No. As in, right. That's what they call that.
Oh. Well.
No, huh?
Oh, really?
All right.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, here we go, Glenn Weiss. These two new statues in the park, Glenn. One is President Grant on his horse. The other is President Ford on his blank.
Skis?
Skis. Well, he's known. He's known for being a skier. He could be standing there on his skis or going downhill on his skis. What'd you say, Ron?
One was President
Grant
on
his horse.
The other was President Ford on his... Another word for donkey.
He got it in, didn't he? He was very clever.
I tell you, he really scared the heck out of me there.
What do you think? The way he did that.
Yes.
Where did President Ford spend all his time? On his rear end.
On his rear end. Right. Right. You did indeed.
On his rear endo.
The rear endo. Skis is what Glenn is looking for. Pair of skis there, Elaine.
You're not going to believe this.
All right. Did you misunderstand?
No, I didn't. I just think a little differently.
Oh.
So I saw President Grant on his horse, and I thought of President Ford, and I saw him on a Volkswagen Rabbit. That's thinking different.
A horse and a rabbit. Yes. Okay.
Really?
We'll invite you back anyway.
It was the break.
But not very soon.
It was the break.
I see.
Derriere.
Seems to be the definitive answer, Glenn.
Yes, Fannie.
Fannie, naturally. All right. Skis are good. Now, Christy, we have this for you. The country of Nerdo Crumbesia is a terrible place.
How terrible is it?
Straight. Is it?
I really wasn't ready for that. The hotel rooms there are so small, you have to go out into the hall to blank. That's...
Hotel rooms there are so small, you have to go into the hall.
Into the hall to blank. All right.
Get it, sweetheart.
Ready? Here we go. Christy Piper. You've heard of Nerdo Crumbesia?
Oh, yes.
This dreadful little country? Well, the hotel rooms there are so small, you have to go out into the hall to blank.
Sleep?
To sleep.
Oh. Now, wait a minute.
You know why he said, wait a minute? The weirdo might have said sleep also. That's why he said, wait a minute.
That's an excellent answer.
Oh, he said it. One for Christy.
Well, now, she's cute as a button, pretty as a picture, and I say go to bed.
Go to bed. Not necessarily to sleep. Charles?
I said open the closet or drawer.
Open the closet or drawer. All right, now we come to Elaine's. Hotel rooms are so small, you have to go out into the hall to blank. Rim-chomp, bum, bum.
To open your Playgirl centerfold.
Oh, yes. Oh, very interesting.
That's why I'm going to hold it. Open the window.
Open the window. Ring-a-ding-a-ding-a-ding. What do you say?
I thought it was very small, and I said you have to go outside to breathe.
To breathe. What's the old joke? That's it, Johnny Olson. I had a hotel room so small, I'd have gone to the hall to change my mind. Okay, now we'll go to round two. Oh, what do you say, Glenn?
A.
A. All right. This one will be easier. Judy said, Marvin the mailman is really mean.
How mean is he?
Instead of sticking the mail in my mail slot, he stuck it in my blank.
Good, wonderful, excellent. Very good.
No.
Horshack is playing his tricks again.
Funny guy, hey.
All right.
Stuck it in my.
There you go. Yeah. Excellent. Excellent.
Well, there doesn't seem to be any other.
Excellent.
Choice.
That's what I thought.
All right. Bing, 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 bing. Now we come to Glenn Weiss. Judy said, "Marvin the mailman is really mean. Instead of sticking the mail in my mail slot, he stuck it in my blank."
garbage can.
Oh! Is this museum self-supporting? Okay, she said garbage can. What do you say?
Mouth.
Mouth. That would be a mean thing to do, wouldn't it? Okay, Brett.
Don't hit my mouth.
Right in the mouth there. Chuck.
What sort of godfather, all four parts. Mouth.
Elaine, she says garbage can.
Mouth.
You said mouth. And he says mouth. Oh. And Fannie says mouth, and that means Christy Parker wins the day. Glenn, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. Good luck
in your endeavors and in your teaching career in scuba diving. Glenn Weiss, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to send her some gifts and our best wishes. Now we got this just for you. Here we are. We're just funning around here, having a good time, waiting for you to come back. Christy Piper's won her sixth game. Boy, she's getting close to the all-time high here. It's at $7,100 now. Shall we proceed?
Yes, please.
Here it is, Christy. We polled a bunch of people in this very room one day not too long ago. We said, you write down the best answer you can think of to this. Rush to blank. Remember, it's $500 for matching the most popular, $250 the second, and $100 for the third. And let's see what support you'll get.
Richard, please.
It's a football expression. What is it? Rush to...
Rush to...
Can't think what it is.
Oh, no, that was a name of a movie, wasn't it?
Yes, Rush.
Rush to...
Hey, what?
Rush to the longest...
No, Rush to Glory. Was that the name of a movie?
Sure, that wasn't Road to Glory.
I thought it was a football. I'll say Rush to Work.
Rush to Work.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fannie, please.
Rush to Leave.
Rush to Leave. Boy, that went over with a thud. A thud, Fannie.
Haven't you ever heard about, well, I'm in a rush to leave?
Your flags are wilting.
Well, I think that's going to be a good one. Mark my word.
Brett, please.
Well, now let me see.
Here, this is a good one.
Let's see. Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. She's thinking.
Oh.
Rush to her lonely arms.
No.
Rush to go. Rush to...
I told you to go before we left the house.
Rush to go.
Rush to work and rush to leave. They've certainly given you a lot of help, haven't they, Christy? Uh-huh. Now, think about it carefully. You may think of a better one than the three they've given you. What do you say?
Rush to work.
Is that about as good as you think you're going to come up with? Okay. Let's find out if it's up there anywhere, and if so, where. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Rush to the...
Yeah. Oh, well, they won. Rush to go. You got one match, hon.
I don't understand that. It must have been eight people. Everybody ran out, and a few people wrote this. Anyway, here we go with the next one. If you please, slide the $250. Rush to the hospital. Isn't it nifty the way all the answers are showing up that you got from over there, then? All right, here is the last chance for Rush to Work. May we see it, please. You got it. Attaboy, Richard. Very good judgment. Now, Christy, you've picked up another $500. Going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And you know what you have to do that.
Okay, Richard.
All right, you're going to try and match Richard. Here we go. Good luck to Christy Piper. She would go over the $10,000 mark substantially if she does this. Here it is. Blank Harbor. H-A-R-B-O-R. Blank Harbor. Blank Harbor. Christy, give us an answer which you think will match Richard's. We give you $5,000.
Boat.
Oh! Boat Harbor. You certainly know how to warm the cockles of our heart. Richard, Boat Harbor, she says, will match you for $5,000.
Well, this was an obscure answer I gave.
Nobody's ever heard.
Yeah, it's a pearl.
Pearl Harbor.
Well, she probably
yes. Would. Excellent answer.
Last week, she hadn't heard the fly in the ointment, right. So probably
December 7, 1942. Well, Pearl Harbor is seems... What else would you say? 41. Boston Harbor, the Tea Party occurred there. Anyway, Christy, you're going to meet another player now. If you're ready, we'll do that. Bring on Bonnie Middlebrook. Here we go. Hi, Bonnie. You know Christy?
Yes.
You look like a happy lady.
Oh, yeah.
What have you got to be happy about, Bonnie?
Well, I have a wonderful husband. He's a fireman.
Yeah.
And a little boy, 3, named Jack. And Dina, 2. She's a little girl. And my good luck.
What is that?
My good luck. My nephew sent 3 rabbit's feet.
3 rabbit's feet. Well, good luck to you, my dear.
Thank
we can't
you.
Start at this moment. We're going to do a little business with America. But you hang around. Now you watch this. All right. Thank you very much, Johnny Olson. Here we go. Bonnie, if you're ready, you may have A or B.
Please.
B it is for Bonnie.
Bonnie.
Hi.
I'm rehearsing.
He's rehearsing his poem.
Oh, I see.
Shows, you know.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Who do I have to applaud now? The contestant?
No.
The MC?
Just listen to what I have to say
Christmas
here.
Cheer.
I want to know, Charles, if you
sorry,
heard...
I'm sorry, but I have things. I've got a last-minute cards I'm trying to get out for Christmas.
Merry All Christmas right. Anyway, Charles.
Got my ID
Charles,
and everything.
Have you heard about... Have you heard about Dumb Donald?
Yes.
Would you like to hear about Dumb
yes,
Donald?
I
Say
guess
yes,
so.
Charles.
Gotta kill the time till a turkey.
Dumb Donald wanted to find his roots, so he went to a blank. Now think about it for a second. Dumb Donald wanted to find his roots, so he went to a blank.
Another answer.
Yeah, there are 2 really good choices here that I can think of. There are probably a lot more.
Do you know the zip code of Bristol, Connecticut?
No.
He was doing a very nice poem for you. Well, listen, he was just trying it out on me to
All
see
right.
if you'd like it.
Bonnie, Dumb Donald. He wanted to find his roots, so he went to a blank.
A nursery.
A nursery. All right. Wanted to find his roots, so he went to a nursery.
Tree surgeon.
Tree surgeon.
That's a match.
No, not...
That's not a match.
A tree surgeon is not a nursery. I'm sorry, Ron, but nice try. You're really fighting for her. Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Hey. Can you see by
the dawn's early light? Cut. Yes.
You're going to throw the first ball out?
Yes.
I was thinking...
What were you thinking about?
Of my answer. Where are you going?
Well,
no, there's no water
me,
in there. Those are plastic, huh?
He asked me if
nobody's
I was
going to...
We just sang
that.
The Star Spangled Banner, and then after that, you got to throw the first ball out. And there
Thing.
It is.
Thing.
Now,
well,
to carry
I was,
on.
I was trying to think of... What was the question?
The question was, Dumb Donald wanted to find his roots, so he went to a...
Now, I looked down at that head, and then I looked over at that head, and the first thing that came to my mind was hairdresser.
Hairdresser. Roots, hair. Okay, that's a good one, Charles.
I hope so. I said greenhouse.
A greenhouse.
That head.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho.
You're not ho. I'm so disappointed you're not in costume, Charles. I really am. It's we're all full of goodwill and good cheer. And
well, show an old tape from one of the years when you used to allow me to do it.
What do you say?
I said to find his roots.
Yeah.
He went to a gardener.
A gardener. Now, let's think about it. No, gardener. No, that's not. It's the same wavelength, but not exact enough. Richard?
This could be a match. Barber.
Barber. Well, close, but they didn't give it to you. Right.
I accept their ruling.
Not a nursery. Yes.
Well, I've gone totally different from anybody.
You have?
Yeah. I said he went to his dentist.
Aha! Tooth. Yeah, very good. Excellent. All right. So there we are in the middle of round 1. She picked up 1. Now we've got this for you, friends. I hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 77, and between now and then that you'll have a very merry, wonderful Christmas.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
ready to match the stars from Welcome Back, Cotter, Ron Palillo, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Thank you for joining us, friends. Hey, yeah.
Sky Masterson.
This is a little late for the Christmas, a Christmas red, but I'm a day late. Where's Charles?
Who cares?
Now, wait a minute.
Charles. I don't give a darn. That's Charles. The way I am. I'm the idea.
What are you drinking, Chuck?
There's nutmeg or cinnamon in here.
I use a little bit of both, mostly nutmeg, just a dash of cinnamon.
I had a wonderful time.
What have you been doing? It's a day after Christmas. What have you been doing?
I have been playing Santa Claus on all the important shows, the shows that wanted me to play Santa Claus. Hollywood Squares. Stop the Music. What's My Line that got me right away? Tell the Truth, Chris Kraft, Do-Re-Mi. Everything. Tic-tac-toe. I had 81 drinks.
That's why you're late, is it?
I also composed...
An epic poem.
That's clever. Okay. It has one rhyme I'm not too happy with, but I'll go anyway.
All right.
That's what we were working on before.
Merry Christmas. Anyway, I don't want a dry eye in the house.
Okay, the Kleenex. Throw the box of Kleenex over, please. We got to get ready in case we are moved.
You think a new year he'd be able to throw it once?
That's right. 5 years. He's never learned how to throw the box of Kleenex.
A year.
I need one too.
Oh, of course. Yes.
I mightn't get through the bad rhyme part. There's one part that I'm not too happy with.
Go ahead, dear.
I can be Kris Kringle. On every show but here. But I don't have to be my friends. The answer's very clear. You see, there is a Gene, Virginia, my dear. And on Match Game 78, this is the part. It'll be Christmas every day of the new year.
Charles.
I thought it was beautiful.
I think it's beautiful. We're quite touched.
Hit the jackpot, loved it.
You will notice he has only one sideburn.
No, I really, this is nice. It's fun to do this. But I didn't play it last year, and you know I was upset.
Well, all right, now promise.
And you know why I'm not playing it next year?
Now, wait
CBS
a minute.
CBS is so cheap, they didn't even get a beard. I mean, you want to discuss it?
Now, next year, let's get a commitment. We'll get a commitment right now. Next year, he'll play Santa Claus, right? Right. Okay. All right. Hello, Christy Piper and Bonnie Middlebrooks. These two ladies here are competing. And we're in the middle of round one, right? Christy's our current champ. She has $7,600. Bonnie has matched one celebrity in our first round question. We'll see how Christy does with hers right after we see about this. Ho, ho, ho. We are ready to carry on. Christy, this is your first round question. Everyone will play. Muggsy said, hey, let me tell you how tough my neighborhood was. Boy, my neighborhood was tough. They called my high school Blank High. That's how tough my neighborhood was. They called my high school Blank High.
I think I hate that question.
No, that's a good one.
And we worked on the poem. On airtime, we worked on the poem.
Well, that was the problem. Should have been done. Plan ahead.
Put your D up here.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, now.
Really tough neighborhood. They call the high school Blank High. Come on now, you got kids.
I got kids.
Now say peekaboo.
Kids. What's the matter with kids today?
Good, sing it all. You are so cute when you sing that. I can't think of a thing.
Come on now, think of something.
Come on now, we got to play this game.
Everybody down here is ready. Well, we're going to start
with wait.
Christy. Okay, she's ready. Muggsy said, let me tell you how tough my neighborhood was. They called my high school Blank High.
Get High.
Get High. Now, Christy grasped the idea rather quickly, I thought.
Indeed, she did. Very high.
Very high.
Well, get.
Get high, very high. Santa Stinko Award. Is that what you're giving her for this response she's going to show us now?
We shouldn't do everything the same way all the time. I think that sometimes if you just have to take someone's word for it that they don't match.
Okay.
Okay.
You don't match.
I don't match. Right. I promise you. Yes. It's the truth.
No, come here.
I'll just show it. You see, now I don't match.
Let me see.
It's not a match. I couldn't.
Now, there is an all-time low. Top high.
Yeah. I don't think anything. I'm more to be pennies than censured.
That's right. Poor lady.
Notice I didn't mention you in my poem. I said always high.
Always high. Christy said get high or getting high.
I still don't understand that question.
That's what they call my high school. What do you say, Elaine?
I said coolie high.
Coolie high.
What does that mean? Like, I'll keep one
what
second
that?
To get.
Well, is that a tough high school?
I don't know. There was a movie and I never saw it.
Yeah, it was.
So I don't know if it was tough or it was Disney or what. I don't know.
It's really tough, isn't it?
Tell me, in a tough neighborhood, they call my high school Blank High.
Alcatraz High.
Alcatraz High. That's a good one.
Richard.
What do you say, Fanny?
I met Santa Claus. Always high.
Always high. Yeah. All right. So there we are. And a round one, 1-0 in favor of Bonnie. Round two coming up. You may have A or B.
E.
B for Bonnie again. Okay. Fatima.
I thought Cooley was good.
Wrong.
I think it was next to mine.
Fatima, the harem girl, said... You've seen her, have you? Fatima, the harem girl, said, believe me, it's not easy to get blank on a bed of nails.
You can't say that, can you?
Let's see. Charles, you do not play.
Santa does not play.
I beg your pardon. Santa does not play.
Still on my face, too. Doesn't itch at all.
No. You'll be all right. Okay.
All right.
Everybody's ready. Bonnie, Fatima the harem girl said, believe me, it's not easy to get blank on a bed of nails.
Made love to?
It's not easy to get make love to.
Made love to.
Oh, to get made love to. To get made love to on a bed of nails. There's something lacking in your sentence diagramming and structure there. What do you say?
Well, that was my first idea, and then I said, get any sleep.
Get any sleep. You rejected your first thought,
well,
and we told you not to do that.
I didn't think of another word for it.
Go to the back of the class. Hello, Brett.
Hi, hon. I'm not so ashamed of this one. I said, get a good night's rest.
A good night's rest. Okay.
Thank you.
She said, made love to. It's not easy to get made love to on a bed of nails, Elaine.
Hello. Oh, yes, it isn't.
It isn't. You've tried it.
Oh, what am I saying? No, I mean, listen, what the heck. I said seduced.
That's one. Okay, Bonnie, you got two now. Richard?
What's really difficult is to get pregnant.
That is tough.
It's next to impossible.
Right. I have no comment.
Oh, come on.
No.
I just said, sexy, get sexy.
Make love to, they're thinking about it. No. No, they said no. So that means two for her, and yours is yet to come, so you hang around. Now you watch this. Now, we are going to finish this game. Well, maybe we won't finish this game, because if you match two, Christy, it'll end up in a tie. If you match three, we will indeed finish the game, and you will have won your seventh game. Jake said, he says, I don't think my boss appreciates suggestions. In the middle of the office, there's a blank with the word suggestions printed on it. You don't understand me. Jake said, I don't think my boss appreciates suggestions. In the middle of the office, there's a blank with the word suggestions printed on it.
I get it. Now, I got it before. When they weren't getting it, I was getting
good,
it.
Good.
Stuff. It's the easy stuff that's hard for me to get.
Good.
Now,
splendid.
See, that's not like that.
Right. Okay, here we go. Christy Piper. Here it is. Come on, Charles, put it in the slot there. Jake said, I don't think my boss appreciates suggestions. In the middle of the office, there's a blank with the word suggestions printed on it.
A trash can or a garbage can?
Trash can, okay. So she needs two of those to tie and three to win. There's one. Waste paper basket matches trash can. Brett?
Waste paper basket.
Now we got a tie. What? Wait a minute. Well, hold on.
Come on.
Now, wait a minute. Hold just... Quiet! I may agree. She said trash, basket, or garbage can.
Trash or garbage is a garbage can.
And that does not make a waste paper basket. The reason I thought it did is because I heard the bell ding, you see. Your dinger went a little too fast. Now, all right, so you've got another...
The dinger went crazy, yes. Didn't it, sweetheart?
What do you got there?
Santa's very nervous.
Yes.
I said a wastebasket.
A wastebasket from Santa. Merry Christmas.
Well, it's over.
A wastebasket is not a trash or garbage can. Elaine, what do you say to this?
Hefty.
Hefty bag. No,
I said incinerator.
Incinerator. All right. Now, for you to achieve a tie, Christy, you must match Richard and Fannie. In the middle of the office, there's a blank with the word suggestions printed on it. She says a trash can or a garbage can?
So do I.
Garbage can. All right. So there's one. Score is now 2-1. And Fannie.
Well, you know, I said he put a toilet in.
Yeah, there's a... So that means Bonnie Middlebrooks wins the game. Well, Christy, you've been around here for a long time, and we've enjoyed meeting you and playing Match Game 77 with you. You're leaving here with $7,600.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Christy. Bye. Here's Bonnie Middlebrooks. Now, she's going to try for the big money.
Yay.
You ready? All right. Yay. Not too long ago, we polled a studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank. Public. Remember, you get $500 for matching their most popular answer and for matching the second most popular, $250, and $100 for the third, and three of our celebrities will help.
Richard.
My public.
Fannie.
Notary public.
And Charles.
Santa chooses not in public.
All right, not in public, my public, and notary public. Do you want one of those, Bonnie, or do you want to give us one of your own?
I think I'll go with notary.
Notary public is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Okay. May we see the $100 response? John Q. Public. Let's see if we get a notary public under the next one, please. General public. Last chance for the notary go. Yes, congratulations. All right. Now, Bonnie, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. You have to choose one celebrity.
Yes. Richard.
Okay. Good luck to you. Here it is, worth $5,000. And this is it. Blank wool. W-O-O-L. Blank wool. Blank wool. Blank wool. All right, Bonnie, what answer would you like to give us that'll match his and get you the $5,000?
My first thought was pure wool.
Pure wool will match you for $5,000, she says. Richard, what do you say to that?
I said steel. Oh.
Steel wool. All right, steel wool. Bonnie, you've picked up a total of $600 here, and you're going to meet another player later, right after we do a little business with America. And now let's all welcome Carol Posebon. How are you from, Carol? Where?
Temple City.
Temple City. Anything else you want to tell us about you?
Well, I'm married and I have a little boy, Ryan, who's 3, and I work part-time as a dental assistant and part-time at a printing company.
All right. We're delighted to meet you, Carol. Wish you the best of luck, and here we go.
Thank you.
You may have A or B.
A, please.
A it is, and it reads as follows. Steve said, I don't trust my doctor. Yesterday he gave me a prescription that was written in blank. I don't trust my doctor. Yesterday he gave me a prescription that was written in blank.
Cute. You
I think it's a good one.
You're talking about you, sweetheart. Oh, cute. I love you in red.
Thank you.
Your door with your little dark,
that's my
dark
post-Christmas red outfit there.
Did you have a nice Christmas?
Yes, did you?
Yeah. Did you get everything you wanted?
Yes, indeed.
Well,
did you?
What'd you get?
That's good. That's
yes,
good.
I got a stationary exercise bicycle.
Let me take this opportunity.
Give
me a beautiful diamond bracelet. You know what Brett gave me? Brett gave me a stainless steel paper clip.
Okay, did you finish, Fanny?
Uh-uh.
No! You're doing all that talking, not even... Come on, Fan.
I forgot the question.
Oh, the question was about... person not trusting the doctor because he wrote the prescription in blank. That was the question.
Okay. Steve said, I don't trust my doctor. Yesterday he gave me a prescription that was written in...
Chinese.
Chinese. Okay, Ron, what'd you say?
Pig Latin.
Pig Latin. Brett?
What did I say?
Yeah.
I said crayon.
Ka-ha. Excuse me. Yes, sir.
Are you all right?
Yes, fine.
I said English.
English! Splendid answer. Don't trust a doctor who writes plain English. They got a scrawl. Elaine?
I said in the dark.
Oh, another goodie. Got some wonderful ones here.
Pig Latin.
Pig Latin. And Fanny says...
He wrote it in blood.
Oh, wow. That would be painful. Well, we had some wonderful answers there. Now, Bonnie, this one is yours. Santa Claus said... He said, my agent is ruining my image. Instead of a commercial for toys, he wanted me to do a commercial for blank. Santa Claus is ruining my image. Instead of a commercial for toys, my agent wanted me to do a... My agent is ruining my... Oh, Santa, I don't know what it says there. It says, my agent said...
Now, is there something you want to tell Santa?
He said a commercial for toys. He wanted me to do a commercial for... Okay!
Okay. Thank you, Santa. Here we go. Bonnie Middlebrooks. Santa Claus said...
Well, Santa Claus better change his.
All right.
Maybe we should change our Santa Claus. Santa is very slow.
Now you know why I said tough high school the other day.
Noel, no.
Santa Claus said...
All right, all right. Santa's slow. Had a busy weekend.
Santa Claus said, my agent is ruining my image. Instead of a commercial for toys, he wanted me to do a commercial for...
Booze.
Well, that would ruin his image, wouldn't it, Ron?
Yeah, well, you know those commercials say, hi, you don't know who I am, but...
Right.
Charge cards.
Charge cards. Okay. Yes?
You know those commercials that say, hey, Merry Christmas.
Hey, there's one for her. Yes, Santa?
Cinnamon or nutmeg in yours?
Nutmeg. Much better.
Booze.
2 for Bonnie. Okay, Elaine.
We'll make it a triple. Booze.
3 for you. That's most unusual. Santa Claus said, my agent is ruining my image. Instead of a commercial for toys, he wanted me to do a commercial for...
Sharma.
Sharma.
As in, please don't squeeze these.
I see. All right. You, Fanny.
Booze.
Booze. So there we are at the end of round one. 4-0 favor the champ. Now we've got this just for you. Well, listen, I do hope you'll be able to join us next time. I hope this past weekend was splendid for you. It was grand for you. Thank you, Charles, for finally showing.
I want to thank everyone that's asked me to be Santa. I just know I'm trying to uphold my image. It's
you'll
wonderful.
Be Santa next year, and I we hope you'll join us tomorrow for Match Game 77. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Taubman production.